Hello everyone, let's talk about the four types of variations, namely direct, inverse, joint, and combined. So we have four types of variations. We have the direct, the inverse, joint, and combined. So when we say direct, two quantities increase or decrease at the same time. And in a mathematical sentences, it is read as y varies directly as x. So in equation or in mathematical symbol, we have y is equal to kx, where your k is the constant of variation or the constant of proportionality. Then we have the other type, the inverse. The inverse means that one quantity increases while the other decreases or vice versa. So, in a sentence, it is read as y varies inversely as x. In a mathematical equation or symbol, this is written as y is equal to k over x. So that is inverse variation. Joint variation is actually an inverse variation that involves two or more variables. So usually in a sentence, it is read as y varies jointly as x and w. So in a symbol, we have here the equation y is equal to k times x times w. So, in combined variations are combinations of the variations stated above. So, it can be a combination of direct and inverse or a joint and inverse variation. So, in a sentence, we have this word, y varies directly as x and inversely as w. So, in a mathematical equation, it is written as y is equal to k times x over w. Okay, so this is the summary of the equations for the four types of variation. So when we have this one, for the direct, you have y is equal to kx or y over x is equal to k. So, when you solve for the constant of variation or constant of proportionality, you have this one, k is equal to y over x. Then, for the inverse, you have y is equal to k over x, or if you want to find the value of your constant of variation, so we have k is equal to x times y. Then, for the joint, you have y is equal to k times x times w, or if you wish to find the value of your constant of proportionality, you have your k is equal to y over x times x, y divided by x times w. And then for the combined variation, you have y is equal to k times x over w, or if you wish to find the value of your constant of variation, you have k is equal to y times w divided by x. So remember that your equation, the variables that you are going to use in your equations, will just depend on the variables used in a given problem. Okay, let us have some examples. Write an equation of variation for the following statement. The circumference C of a circle varies directly as the radius R. So, if we are going to write a mathematical equation for that, or equation of variation, it is written as C is equal to k times the radius r, k times r. So that is a direct variation. Next, we have the volume V of a cylinder varies directly as the height h and the square of the radius r. So it is represented by the equation, the volume of a cylinder varies directly as the height h, and the square of the radius r. Okay, so that is our equation of variation. The number three, we have the weight of a body B above the Earth's surface varies inversely as the square of the distance from the center of the Earth. So that is an inverse variation. So it is represented by the equation. We have B is equal to K divided by the square of D. Okay, so B varies inversely as D squared. Next, number four, we have P varies inversely as T. So it's just as easy. P is equal to K over T. So that's it. Number five, y varies jointly as the square of x and w. So it can be written as y is equal to k times, so this is a joint variation, x times w. That's our equation. How about number six? We have r varies jointly as x and z. So it's just written as r is equal to k times x and z. So that is our equation. Number seven, w varies directly as y and inversely as z. So w is equal to k times y and then inversely as z. So that's our equation. Then next we have j varies jointly as the square of l and n and inversely as m. That is m, not n. Okay, that is m. So in symbol or an equation, j is equal to k times, so it is jointly as the square of l, so you have l squared and then n divided by m, inversely as m. So that is how we write the equation of variation of a given statement.